I am Bad Wolf, and what I'll be showing you today is how to get secret items from fishing. There are a lot of spoilers in this video, so if you don't want spoilers, you probably shouldn't watch this video. So first we'll start with the items that are easier to get that you could get early in the game. The first item is going to be the boat painting. So for this item, you need to have the beach farm to be able to get this. So it's located, the fishing area is located kind of southwest on the farm. So we'll just head down here. And there's actually a little secret passageway here. Alright, so let's see if we can get this. Nice, I think we got it. Alright, so we got our boat painting. So why don't we go to the house and see what it looks like when we put it up. Alright, it's pretty big actually. So that's it. So the next item you can actually get from fishing over by the community center. This is going to be the decorative trash can. You can also get this from the furniture catalog. Yay, finally got it. There is only a 10% chance of getting it, so I did have to fish for a little bit to get this. Alright, so we got our decorative trash can. And, you know, you might be thinking, why would I want a decorative trash can? You know, I like to have Krobus as a roommate, and I feel like it goes with the aesthetic of his room, because his room basically looks like a sewer, and it's kind of like a grayish green color. But, you know, you could just put it outside your house or whatever, and it looks like a normal trash can. Alright, so the next item we're going to get is the Vista painting. So this is something that you would get by fishing over at the spa. Now, the spa you're not going to have access to until the 3rd of spring, year 1. That's when an earthquake occurs that kind of clears the stuff blocking the way. So let's head over there. Alright, so the spa is right here north of the carpenter shop. Alright, here it is. And you should be able to get this the first time you fish in this area. It's not something where you have to do it 10 times to get it. So let's put it up and see how it looks. All right, my walls are a bit cluttered, but we're gonna put it right here. There you go, it's a lovely painting. So the next item we're gonna get is the wall basket. You can get this from fishing over in the secret woods. You do need to have at least a steel axe to cut down that log that blocks the way to the secret woods to be able to get this. So let's head over. And for anyone who doesn't know, the secret woods is over here. South of your farm, you kind of pass this pond, this area where the traveling cart is. And it would be right through here. All right, we finally got it. There's only an 8% chance to get this, so you might have to fish for a while to get it. And you can get more than one. If you keep fishing, you can keep getting them if you want a couple to decorate your house. All right, so let's put this up. And there it is. Might look good in the kitchen. My kitchen walls are kind of filled up with stuff. All right, so the next item is the pyramid decal decoration. So this you can get by fishing in the South Pond over in Calico Desert. To get over to Calico Desert, you have to complete the vault bundles in the community center. Those bundles just cost money. So it costs 42,500 gold to complete all of the vault bundles. The vault bundles don't open up until after you've completed four bundles in the community center. If you're min-maxing, you can get that done in spring year one. So let's go over to the pond here. This is gonna look a little bit weird, but this is where we fish from to get this. All right, nice. Second try. There's only a 10% chance of getting this, so you might have to fish for a while to get this one too. All right, so let's head back to the farm and see how it looks when we put it up. All right, looks pretty nice. So the next item we're going to get is the Lifesaver, which you can get from fishing in the back room of Willy's Fish Shop. Now, you won't have access to that back room until you either complete the community center bundles or you complete the Joja community development projects. So let's head down there. So we'll just go to this back room here. All right, here it is. So let's see how it looks when we put it up. All right, so there's the Lifesaver. Now there is a 20% chance of getting that item, so you might have to fish for a little bit to get it. All right, so the next item we're gonna get is the Foliage Print painting. So this you would get over on Ginger Island. You have to either complete the community center or Joja to get over to Ginger Island. So, it's kind of on the northwest part of the island. So, if you're heading straight up from the dock, you're going to cut over to the left here and you're going to walk through this bush area. Come down a little bit, and then you walk all the way over to the left. And you're actually going to cast from right here. All right, so we have our Foliage Print painting here, and let's head back and see how it looks. All right, my house is a little bit cluttered, but we're going to put it up on this wall here. There you go, lovely painting. All right, so the next item we're gonna get is the frog hat. You get this over on Ginger Island from the little cave that's kind of northeast of your farm. It's called the Gourmand Frog's Cave, so we'll just head over there. All right. So, as you can see, it kind of comes up with something else that you get. So, I got a Joja Cola, and this frog hat just kind of popped into my inventory. If your inventory's full, you're not going to be able to get it. And there is a 10% chance of getting this. You might have to fish for a little bit. All right, so the next item that we're gonna get is the Gourmand Frog Statue. So you get this from Pirate's Cove. Pirate's Cove gets unlocked once you build the beach resort over on Ginger Island. So it's kind of on the southeast side of the island. So if you're coming off the dock, it's gonna be kind of to the right of that. So there's kind of this little entrance way into the cave. All right, so we got it. There is only a 5% chance of getting this one, so you might have to fish for a while. I happen to love this statue. I feel like he has character. All right, so let's move on to the next one. So the next item we'll get is the squirrel figurine. To get this, you need to go to kind of a secret fishing spot that you get to through the volcano dungeon on Ginger Island. So you will want to bring your watering can for this. So basically, if you use your watering can, you can make a pathway over the lava. And then you get to this little exit, and you'll want to fish right over on the side here. Right. So we got our squirrel figurine here. You should be able to get this the first time you fish over here. So we'll just head back and we'll see how it looks in the house. There it is. All right, so the next one we're gonna get is the Physics 101 painting. You get this from the volcano caldera over on Ginger Island. So that it's basically an area you get to once you complete the volcano dungeon over there. So let's head over. So once you complete this, you will be able to build kind of an opening just to go directly to the caldera. Yay, we finally got it. So there's only a 5% chance of getting this one. I had to fish for quite a while for this one. You can only get it once as well, so treasure it. All right, so let's take it home and see how it looks. All right, looks pretty good. I think I'm gonna keep this one. All right, so the final item we're gonna get is the Iridium Krobus statue. So for this, you need to have level 15 fishing. Now, you can only get up to level 10 as far as your fishing skill, but then you'll need to eat something that gives you a plus 5 fishing buff. So, the food in the game that has the highest fishing buff is seafoam pudding. Normally, it gives you a plus 4 fishing buff. If you want it to give you plus 5, you have to cook it using key seasoning. Key seasoning is something you can get from Key's Walnut Room over on Ginger Island. So if you have the seasoning in your inventory when you're cooking, it's going to make your cooking items gold quality, and it's going to give plus 1 to the buffs that that food has. So what I do is, you know, I just use the high quality seafoam pudding by cooking it with the key seasoning. Another thing you could do is just use regular quality seafoam pudding. If you have a fishing rod that you enchanted over at the volcano caldera on Ginger Island with the master enchantment, because that will add plus 1 to your fishing skill when you use that fishing rod, then you only need plus 4 fishing from your food item. So that could be regular quality seafoam pudding, or it could be a food item that normally gives you plus 3 fishing that you cooked with key seasoning, so then it gives you plus 4. So that would be dish of the sea, fish stew, or lobster bisque. So the area we go to for this is really south on the map. It's over by that entrance to the sewers. All right, so here we are. This is pretty much directly south, maybe slightly southeast of the farm. And you want to come down as far south as you can on this area in front of the sewer entrance. As you can see, I haven't had Trash Bear clean up this area yet in this save. You will need to do a max cast. The reason you need to be level 15 fishing to get this statue is because you need to be able to cast further out. So you have to do a max cast to get this. Alright, look at our Krobus statue. I think this is the best secret fishing item in the game. Because, of course, Krobus is adorable. He deserves his own statue. You can only get this once per save, so, you know, don't throw it away. And that's about it. I hope this video has been helpful to you. If it has, consider liking the video or subscribing to the channel. I also stream Stardew and other video games over on Twitch. Lately, I've been streaming Stardew on Saturday and playing other games during the week with my husband, Dying Tickles. You can follow us over at www.twitch.tv/wolftickles. Links are in the description. Thanks!